My postdoc, Miranda Sinnott-Armstrong, she found these lantanas were just getting tossed away on Pearl Street and thought, that looks kind of sparkly and it certainly is blue. I'll just take it back to the lab. When we see color in the world, probably people usually assume that it's pigment, right? We use pigment to dye our clothes, to dye our hair. We found one of only two cases where we know for sure that it has nothing to do with the kind of pigments that stain your shirt. Instead, it's just fat that is layered and structured very precisely to reflect blue color. You can learn a lot about what makes color just by doing very, very simple things. Pigments are generally, the ones we work on, water soluble. So you can peel it up and they're just in the body of the cell and squish it and the pigments come right out. This is what happens with most blue fruits. So a blueberry, you squish it and this is what's gonna happen. But this lantana, it doesn't have any blue pigments to make it blue. So when you squish it, you just get this kind of brown smush inside, just kind of like a rotten fruit. It has flesh inside of it, but that flesh isn't colored and neither is the skin. The skin is just clear. There's so much to be discovered and it's right under our nose. I mean, this is only the second ever plant that's been described to make a fruit color, a blue fruit, just by orienting fats in its skin. For people that are curious, discoveries are everywhere. There's so much we don't know about plants and about basically all of, you know, of biodiversity. There's so much to be discovered.